we're going to be building a battery cable. We'll be crimping battery terminals and cable lugs. We'll be using extra flex cable. You'll run into these products in this situation in anything that's automotive. Forklifts, code 17, code 18, which is trucking and heavy industry, code 19, farming, code 20, automotive. You can also use these for crimping lugs in code 12s. Truly, this is something that's used in most of our industry codes. We're going to demonstrate how to crimp battery terminals and cable lugs and make a battery terminal system. This is an RC840B crimp tool for battery terminals and cable lugs. This is a CC830K cable cutting tool. This is an HSG7 shrink gun, BCEF 2-aught RD extra flex battery cable. The part number on these battery terminals is C2T 2-aught PS. These are heavy duty cable lugs in a 2-aught gauge for a 3/8 hole. It's part number CLHD2038. We'll be using shrink tube TSHD12RDS. You're going to have to determine how much cable you need and cut that piece. It may require measuring how far it is from the battery or the battery terminal, the starter or something along that lines. I'm going to cut about a foot off here just to show you how to build these. I'm going to use the cable cutting tool, and in that the jaws on it kind of cross over, squeeze it about halfway through and let the pressure off and go ahead and cut it all the way through. It's just pretty much like a knife through butter, and you can see it makes a nice clean cut. The next thing you've got to determine is how much insulation you need to remove. Take your cable cutter and open it up. This time you're not wanting to cut through the cable, you're just cutting through the insulation. You're not trying to cut any of the wire strands. You simply put a little pressure as you roll the cable and the tool, and you'll see it cutting in through the red insulation and the white insulation. Once it gets through the insulation, if you canter it just a little bit, you can see it pulls apart. You may then need to take and carefully work it off. Just like that, you've got a nice, clean, smooth cut. This is an RC840B crimp tool. It's designed for crimping both battery terminals from a 2-gauge to a 4-aught, as well as tubular lugs from a 4-gauge to a 3-aught. It has the color codes for each size terminal. To adjust the tool, you open it. It's got a threaded die and a little white bar here that you adjust up or down to the proper gauge. We're working on 2-aught today, which you'll know as 2-aught, but you'll also see it as color-coded orange. We're going to adjust this die by rotating this thread up or down to where it adjusts to this line that's orange in color. Just like that. All right, we're going to put this battery terminal in the crimp tool, and we're going to make two crimps between these three lines. We're going to start with the one closest to the battery terminal. You simply lay it in, slowly squeeze the indent, get it to where you want it, right between these two lines. Come over on the other side, start guiding your strands of cable, trying to get them all in there. You may not get them all in there, but you want to push them in and get as tight a seal as you can, just like this. And you begin to squeeze the handles together, and you'll feel the crimp in the tool. You'll hear it knock, and that's when you know you've got a complete crimp. Open the tool back up, and you see we've made one crimp between the two orange lines. We're now going to make a second crimp between the other two orange lines. You simply repeat by putting the terminal in. You line it up for the second two lines and follow through with the crimp again. You've now successfully completed crimping of the terminal. Really? The idea of making two crimps, one crimp would work, but two crimps just creates a more solid mechanical bond in there, allowing more current to travel through this. It makes it a little bit more solid and actually compresses that copper into a solid bar almost. Once you have the crimp made, you still have an open space between the terminal and the insulation. So we're going to apply shrink tube and seal that up to try to make the battery ends last longer. As you're shrinking, you want to start in the center and work your way out. The reason you start in your center is so that you don't create an air bubble inside. So I'm going to turn on the heat shrink gun. It'll take a minute to warm this up. You want to keep your shrink tube moving a little bit so that you don't actually burn any shrink tube. And you see the way it's folding in the middle and shrinking out, and the ends are a little larger. Roll it around. Start shrinking up towards the end, towards the battery terminal. You can see the glue start to come out. You see the little glistening right in here is the glue. And that's about as far as I want to shrink it. Can you see the seal it right inside, right there? As soon as this cools, impurities won't be able to get back into that sleeve. And this would be a completed battery terminal crimp.